But he can use his hook thing. Cool, he is almost dead. And Eretus can finish him off. Nice. Okay. Now, we get our thing going. Which is... heal 6 points of health per turn and plus 100 damage. Now, target itself, that heals me, unfortunately. Anything else I got? One ally. How long does that last? One intellect. 5 uses per day. So I can just heal her that way. Alright. Oh, I healed 11. Nice. Yeah, she's almost at full. That's freaking awesome. Now I can do something else? I can only move. I don't remember where the sorrow goes. Everyone else has moved. I don't want them all to necessarily attack me.
Yes.
So let me just move here. Calistige. Anything else? Oh no, this is one of her, it's her ornament. Choose a damage type. So it just changes all damage to energize? Change... Oh, to any damage type you want. I guess that's good if you know someone who's specifically vulnerable to a certain kind of attack. I should try that. Let's try this, the hide. She's hiding. Let them come to us. I don't know. Oh boy. That leaves me a sitting duck, unfortunately.
Can't say I'm blind.
They activated the his shield thing.
We approve.
Like they're helping him. Ah, I'm getting hurt. Oh, it's over there. Cool, I didn't get pulled and it instead knocked down.
Can't die.
What? Ah. God damn. I was at full. Okay, we need to stay away from there. If that's where it is...
Sure enough.
Just pull everyone to us. As much as we can.
Let's go.
Unfortunately, I can't select people and move them.
Action!
Just
here
stupid.
I come.
Okay, so we should stay over here as much as possible, because they're going to drag us, but we need to, like, run away or something. Alright, so... yeah, hook. Hook, line, and sinker. Fortunately, I stopped him. Damn, he's out of range. Yeah, I can't use that. Hmm. 23 points of health on allies and target. I guess I'll choose hide. I don't know what else to do. I don't want to move him forward, and he can't attack anyway. Well, then again, that thing's over there. Now let's just move him up here. For all I know, it'll attack some from somewhere else anyway. Yeah, he doesn't have the hook thing. Eh. Oh wait, can he use Sucker Punch? I choose you, Pikachu! So I'm gonna use this thing again to heal her. She appreciated that. Now she can move, but I'm gonna keep her here. I'll have her go hide. Well, might as well use it all. Have her move up. Yep. He drag us all over to them so we can get attacked by this frickin' thing. Which is going to be... maybe I should have everyone hide. I think history is going to repeat itself. Don't do anything. Okay, we survived it. Can I attack and then move away? Whose turn is it? Tiber? It's all the way over here. He's okay, I'm damaged. Then again, he has this thing. Healed 23 points of damage. Eritus needs it. Callistus doesn't need it. Nice. Okay, have him move back. Well, we need to fight these guys at the same time. Go in into shadows. Who's the most damaged? They all have 16. This is the guy who has 20. Everyone else has 16. Sucker punch. Nice. That must have been... Now, right. That's a critical hit. Protection for the weary. Unfortunately, he can't move. He's going to be susceptible. Eight physical damage. It's not going to kill any of them. Well, I can heal Tiber. I don't think he's going to be dragged because he's in shadows. I guess we'll find out. We've got three of them with one hit point. I'm hoping that whoever hides won't be susceptible to attack. Out of range. Figures. But she can use... Yeah. Five dimensional damage plus 12. Those still remain. I can track them all. But then again, if I don't drag them away, this thing will kill the other remaining ones. Critical hit. So now we've got what? Just two left? We've got one left. Or two, actually. One and two. And that thing. They both have one hit point left. That's freaking ridiculous. Hide. He's getting up with his one hit point. Yeah, Eretus is going to get it, because he's the only one not hidden. That thing's going to attack. We got three? Oh, they got dragged anyway. It missed, okay. He's got 16 again? Did they get healed somehow? Or was I seeing things wrong? Well, she can't hit that one. he can't hit that one. Ridiculous, with one hit point. Eretz's turn. Just kill this guy.
You never had a chance.
Well, this guy laying down. Ten plus nine. Okay guys, we actually made it. This is farther than we have ever made it. Go. I'm hoping there's not a battle after this. 12 shins and a battle axe. Not useful.
All right.
Hopefully find some other things. Healing or something. 11 shins and a buzzer. Just gonna sell it.
Go.
14 shins and a buzzer. 13 shins and a dagger. Damn it. In one of our battles last time, we found at least a spray flesh. We don't have one this time. So he's got 23 out of 36. He's got 29 out of 48. I don't know what we will meet on the other side, so I'm going to save here. I don't know if there's another battle, so I don't want to... Yeah. New, episode at this point. Yeah, I don't want to waste my items. I mean... She does need her intellect back and her speed. And... I could use some intellect. A little speed, but we don't have that much, and then... He's out of speed. But I don't think all we have is concentrated splay flesh and the intellect amplified encephalic rush. What a rush. So definitely we need more stuff. And Eretus has a concentrated splay flesh. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to give it to Calistige. Because first of all, she's always hurt. Second of all, she can teleport. Hopefully, to the character, and then use it. So that's the only actual change I'm gonna make. I was trying to X the box, but there's nothing there.
I'm ready. I'm always ready.
Yeah, I hope so. I don't know what awaits us here.
Yes.
Hopefully no more of these cultists. Okay, Atawa. Inifere. Well, let's talk to Kiyotawa then. Hopefully we can just talk our way out of this. So I don't know what this means. They're controlled somehow? Mentally? I remember you, she says, cocking her head. You're the investigator Folsom hired when I killed his protege. She smiles. I wondered when you were going to find me. I was worried. She shakes her head. It must sting a little, knowing that you let me get away, that all those people died. Yeah, she killed a lot of people after that. And then we saw her in someone's, in one of the tombs, in one of the, mirror casters. Well, in a mirror, using a mirror caster. I'm not gonna say it doesn't bother me, but I'm here now. Yes, you are, she agrees, but far from Sega's cliffs and the bodies I left behind. You're too late, investigator. The damage is already done. Like letting him know, like Folsom's gonna come here. He'll say it anyway. I'll be sure to let Folsom know where you are. Do that, she says blandly. I doubt I'll live long enough to see a single assassin. You think you're going to die here? Look around you. Does this look like the kind of place you live a long, healthy life? Why did you kill those people in the underbelly? To open the road here, she says in a monotone, looking away, to find peace. She furrows her brow. Peace. I should have known I'd find you here. What? She says, barking a laugh, glancing at the man beside her. You think I've found a place of honor here? They don't trust me. None of them do. She snorts again, but she isn't smiling. Why don't they trust you? Her face tightens as though in pain. Because I'm one of them, the flesh eaters. They wanted to release me when I arrived, but Inifere stopped them somehow. Gods know why, but I'm not leaving his side. Right. And she thinks, even here, I'm not. Inifere accepts me. He understands, I think. That's right, she was one of the Dendro or her. I'm a flesh eater. At least that's what most of them think. Inifere understands. Coughs. Nothing to see here, huh? We shall see. Hail, Inifere. Inifere, however you say it. This man is long-limbed and bony, unmuscled with a sunken chest, sparse hair on a scarred scalp. Rags hang from his slumping body. He wears the cast-off tattoo, but he's like no cast-off you've seen. He regards you with bloodshot eyes, fever mad. But just as his pupils remain black and pure amid the veins, you sense something hard and sane within the madness. His words are hoarse and dangerous. You've come too far. Too far by far. There was no escape. None leave the gate. And he thinks, hope, no hope, speak or not, she will die here or not. Should not have come. That's a run-on sentence. But again, you are just thinking it, so I can't really go about grammar, can I? Such a pretty sister. Father's loving touch on every inch of you. Born to run among sunlit lilac, Salah, singing hey-li, hey-li to the gustless strum. Such splendid, splendid dreams. He scrapes at a lesion on his arm and cocks his head, listening. But you're the one who fell, aren't you? We smelled you cooking in the sky. Always a black omen, a falling star. Our Father in heaven never showers gifts. No, sows trouble. And the reaper comes to harvest. Crops we all are, till we come a cropper. Come a cropper! Remember that from a Stephen King story. Now you've wandered far away to where woe holds sway, poorly choosing who you choose, or poorly choosing when you choose. Choose woes? Here beyond the gate, hate, hate, hate. He smirks, but you cannot tell if it's part of his madness or the hint of a method to it. The children love playmates. Your nieces, nephews, they've learned wild lessons as if from father's lips. Pain, pain, taught with teeth, father did. And I gobbled up every scrap. Now he sneers. But he kissed you, didn't he? Perhaps that's the sharper bite. He sees the twisted mirrorcaster in your possession. Oh, we just got that. So we could have reached here without that, and things would have went differently at this point. Possibly. And his eyes creak open, a sudden hunger and anger laid bare in them. Then it is gone, but you notice he glances at the mirrorcaster every few moments, as though to assure himself it is still there. He thinks, life of my life, why does she have it? What will be done? This broken mirrorcaster, it's yours, isn't it?
I'll remember that.
Locked, little sister, not broken, or better yet, disarmed, unfanged. I scoured far and burrowed deep to make this mine primed for my mind. Set to blast apart the husk our father left behind. He smirks. But did you think it a toy, sister? A spyglass to scry past where your eyes can see? An iron bar to pry me open? A way to wallow in the soiled, oily wake I've left upon the tides. I found it, hid it, locked it. In your hand, it's just ballast, nothing more. No, I didn't think it was actually had anything to do with you. Well, I kind of guessed it would. It did. I think you wanted it found. Why else would you hide it in a tomb that is tied so closely to you? I don't want to ask those questions. Inifere blinks twice and swallows. He seems taken aback by your suggestion. But why? He asks finally, as if doubting his own mind. Why would I want it found? He thinks, I don't, but then I don't do. He does always he. Because you want someone to look into it and understand you. Blue tide, small amount. Gold tide, tiny amount. Inifere scoffs. You're not the first to flash that fly above me, thinking I'll strike. But I see the barbs hiding inside, ready to hook me at the first bite, ready to drag me out to where you can gut me, grope about inside me, grabble and garble and gobble what you want of me. He shakes his head. No, little sister. I'll stay down in the muck, and that bauble will stay safe in its lock. I'm better with persuasion. I do want to get back to those other questions. Wish I had chosen that, but maybe it would have led nowhere anyway. You're not a fish, Inifere, and I'm not an angler. We're in the same boat, and we need to pull together. Success! Inifere stares at you, and you watch as tiny capillaries burst in his eyes, red wounds in the already bloodshot whites. His raw lips form half-made words that go unspoken. Each hand scrapes the other, raising pink ridges like dunes in the sunset. At last he nods, and takes the mirror caster in his hands, twisting and turning it without his eyes ever leaving yours. He hands it back. Have it, he says. Have it all. Darkness comes, not quite over you, so much as out of you, as if your eyes were rolling back and staring into the black recesses behind them, into the blacker morass of your mind, and into something blackest of all beyond that. Pretty black. You feel it in your marrow, your fingertips, your gut, a stab of reflective pain, an electric sensitivity, an upheaval of unwholesome chime. You're remembering a memory of a moment you've never lived, a memory awash in self-loathing. Then the darkness becomes absolute.